the dress, the kind of prevalence. In a sense, it was like, yeah, like a call out or in of like artists, which I don't think is like the main way we intended it. I think initially we just felt that, yeah, I guess that was a big part of it, but I don't think it's like, I don't think it's like the central like plank or whatever, but it was definitely part of the like impulse of the piece, was to sort of like think about like why people hadn't wanted to boycott or like to kind of like encourage the possibility of a boycott. But that kind of evolved as we wrote it. But I think it was around this idea, because you referred to like exercising your privilege by saying no. I think we wanted to kind of debunk that. I don't think saying no, I think historically and even in present day, I don't think the people who tend to be the agents of refusal are privileged. People tend to do what, you know, in the sense of like people who have bourgeois access in some way tend to not say no. They tend to say various forms of yes. You tend to like be like affirming institutions, whether you affirm them by being the person the institution already likes or by kind of holding yourself into that or whatever, or by like kind of insisting that the institution accepts you, whatever. Those are all forms of saying yes. They are expressions of privilege. They're ways you like express an identity between what you're about and what the existing institution is about. So I'd say that was actually, people who say no, it's kind of where you align yourself with like a kind of less privileged situation. It makes me think a bit about something I saw recently about now there's an idea that like not vote, this doesn't relate to the current American elections, there's an idea that like not voting is privilege. It's like, you're so privileged, you don't understand that Trump is bad. Actually, people who don't vote tend to be poor working class people vote way in way lower numbers than middle class people. So this is, and I think it's maybe also what Alice was saying about the ways people like there's existing kind of innovation that happens sort of socially and through, and actually like workers in terms of like yeah, I guess in terms of like thinking about the sort of like, if there's a weird, I guess it's the same way as imagining that like bourgeois people invented design. It's like, who invented like kind of like inventive and like kind of crazy uses of objects? It's people who kind of have to do that out of a sort of like resourcefulness and a kind of collective like sharing of like the available means of life or whatever. And in the same way, it's like the idea that like people who invented the politics of refusal